Hey friends, welcome to Knack Graphics. In this video, we are going to make this abstract background design. So let's start drawing it. First of all, turn off this align art to pixel grid button and also make sure that the smart guides option is on. Now pick rectangle tool and draw an artboard sized rectangle. Change the stroke size to none, and for the fill color, pick this black color. Come to the layers panel, lock this layer and name it BG, BG for background. Create a new layer and name it design. Now pick polygon tool and click on the artboard to open the dialog box. Here enter 150 for radius value and 6 here for the sides. Keep the stroke to none, and for the fill color, come to the color panel, open HSP options. Here dial 240 for hue, 100 for saturation and 8 for brightness. Press Ctrl C to copy this hexagon and press Ctrl F to paste it in front. Now the hexagon in front is selected and we will fill it with a gradient color. Come to the gradient panel. Click here to fill this default gradient in it. Double click this color slider. Open HSP options and here enter 240 for hue, 60 for saturation and 100 for brightness. Set its opacity at 20%. Now click this color slider to select it and set its opacity to 0%. Select this gradient slider and set its location to 35%. And finally, set the angle value of this gradient to minus 36 degrees. Now pick black arrow tool and select both these shapes. Come to the object menu, here pattern and choose make. Press OK for this message. Here in pattern options box, select the tile type to this hex by column. Turn this constraint button off and add 15 pixels to this width and height. Keep the copies to 9x9 and press done here. Now this new pattern has been saved as a swatch here in swatches panel. Just delete these hexagons for now. Now pick rectangle tool and draw an artboard sized rectangle. Keep the stroke size to none and fill it with this new pattern we just designed. Okay, now the basic design is ready. Come to the layers panel and lock this layer. Create a new layer and name it lights. Pick polygon tool now. Come approximately to the center of this hexagon and draw a bigger hexagon while pressing shift key like this. Fill it with this red color and keep the stroke size to none. Keep it selected. Come to the effect menu, blur, here Gaussian blur, and set the radius to 20 pixels. Pick black arrow tool. Pressing down the Alt key, drag out a duplicate of it and place it like this. Change the fill color to this green. Keep it selected and come to the transform panel. Make sure this constraint button is on and increase the width by 20%. Now, again with Alt key pressed, drag out a duplicate of this hexagon and place it like this. Fill it with this cyan color. Come to the transform panel and this time decrease the width by 10%. Now, this hexagon is a bit outside the bounds. To clip it away, pick rectangle tool and draw an artboard sized rectangle. Press Ctrl A to select all the objects of this layer. Come to the object menu, clipping mask and choose make. Alright, now come to the layers panel and drag this layer beneath the design layer like this. Lock this layer, unlock this design layer and make it active as we are going to give a final touch up to the design here. Rectangle tool is on. Draw an artboard sized rectangle. Come to the gradient panel. Click here to apply the currently marked gradient to it. Double click this color slider and pick black color for it. Set its opacity at 40%. Set this slider at 50%. Now make this color slider active. It's already black and we need that only. Change its opacity to 40%. Now click here to add a new color. Set its opacity to 0% and location to 50%. Change the angle value to minus 30 degrees. And finally, come to the opacity panel and change the mode to multiply. These lines appearing on the screen may or may not appear on your system while you're practicing with this design. Not to worry, these are not part of final design and will disappear while final rendering. And here we are, the design is ready. Hit like and share if you like the tutorial. Thanks for watching Knack Graphics. Goodbye for now.